So we're leaving, and then Joey says deadlift. I said, you're kidding, right?
All right, boys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel, hit that like button and subscribe. You don't want to miss out on any future videos. So today we're about to go smash some shoulders. We're gonna try and grow the delts. For pretty much everyone, our shoulders are a necessity to grow. Most people need bigger shoulders in general. So gonna try and grow them, go super hard today, maybe hit some PRs. We're gonna see how we feel. Doing a little Q&A as well, judging by the title and everything. First question, boys, is what's the best pre-workout to take? It's right here in my hand, Vision Pre. You guys know the code. You guys know I also recently just switched sponsors. I absolutely love Vision Pre. It's the best pre-workout I've ever had. The pump on it is ridiculous. So much pump product, and there's so much nootropics in there. Your focus is through the roof. This is my favorite combo. Go a little more than half on each scoop, so it's kind of like 1.5 scoops. Gets you feeling absolutely insane. You go half scoop of the Melon Mania, half scoop of the Arctic Cherry. You mix them together, it's unbelievable. But then the little cheat code, right? So first, shake it up a little bit. Now the secret ingredient to all the pre-workout, make it even better. Put a little bit of candy in there. If you're bulking, I definitely recommend this. A little quick sugar, quick carb, really gets your pump extra focused. I throw about like 5 Sour Patch Kids in there, done. Next question is your best 3 book recommendations. I'm very glad I saw this question come up quite a few times. You guys know I've been reading a lot the last like 6 weeks. So I've only read about like 7 or 8 books on that kind of, you know, self-help, self-transformation books, things like that. The 3 that I would recommend is, number 1 would be, and this is in no particular order, I would read Think and Grow Rich. Anyone that has a business, anyone that wants to kind of get out of the system of being in school and any of that, Think and Grow Rich is great. Really just helps you get motivated with your business ideas and kind of helps just turn them into a fruition. So Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill is a great one. Another one is one of the most recent books I read, The Power of Your Subconscious Mind by Joseph Murphy. That book is amazing. It just kind of truly shows you like how powerful your mind is, and anything that you put your mind to, you can truly do. The power of your mind is literally the most powerful thing you have in your human body. It's not your muscles. It's not any of that. It's your mind. Your mind is the most powerful thing you have. Power of Your Subconscious Mind by Joseph Murphy is amazing. And then the last recommendation that I would say would probably be Meditations by Marcus Aurelius. And what's interesting about that book, if you don't know Marcus Aurelius, by the way, look him up. He was literally one of the most powerful men in his time period. He lived in like 200 AD, something like that, almost 2000 years ago. He wrote this book called Meditations, which originally was only supposed to be like, it was his private thoughts, just like how he could be like a better man in this time period and just be like, literally like the ultimate alpha male, like be him. And these are like his private thoughts. He's like the most powerful man in the world at this time. And it's just like everything that he thought about, like he wrote down, it wasn't even meant to be for the public. It's literally almost like his like journal of the most powerful man to ever exist, one of them. He's a legend. So that book is absolutely amazing. You can really get like kind of any like new translation. I don't remember which one I read by him, but just look up Meditations, Marcus Aurelius, get whatever new standard design, and it's money. That is a phenomenal book. Those 3 are definitely my top recommendations. You have any recommendations for books?
Currently reading American Psycho right now. That is a good thriller read. But top 3, I'm honestly going to go with the first book I've ever read, because it was probably the most beneficial to me, and it really stuck with me. It's called The Game of Life and How to Play It. It's a great book. Another book that he recommended is my also top 3 from my number 2. It is Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. That guy's a genius. That book is very, very, very well written. It was good to read that book because me and Joey are obviously starting Aesthetic Boys up together, so like kind of being on the same wavelength. Reading that book together was a really good thing for us and the business that we started. And number 3, gonna honestly probably go with American Psycho, because it's a great read right now. And I'm currently on the Patrick Bateman grind to get his physique right now. So trying to tap into that character as much as possible. It's a great read.
So yeah, boys, those are some of the book recommendations for right now. I will definitely keep you guys updated as we continue to read more. Currently I'm reading Total Meditation by Deepak Chopra. This is my 3rd book by Deepak. This guy is like a genius, bro. He actually wrote the first book I ever read, which is Unlocking the Hidden Dimensions of Your Life, like the 15 Secrets to Life. That was the first book I ever read, and that was by Deepak. Like, that book was definitely life-changing, really, really beneficial. You learn so much about yourself and just life in general. That's a great author that I definitely recommend as well. I'm probably gonna read more by him. But yeah, boys, if you guys have any other questions about books, feel free to shoot me a DM on Instagram. I will more than likely respond within like a few days, because I do get a lot of DMs like, every day, literally asking book recommendations. So I do hope, kind of touched on this, I can touch on it more in a YouTube video, actually kind of elaborate on kind of the books we're reading rather than just posting like a story post saying like, oh, read this and this. So I'm happy about that I'm able to kind of talk about it with you guys on YouTube. And yeah, boys, we're about to down this pre-workout, get ready for the gym, and go hit a little shoulders. Gonna try and PR on something maybe, and we're gonna try and grow these baby delts because this is the number one priority this offseason, boys. Competing in the men's physique, we need that insane shoulder to waist ratio. I'm not blessed with a genetically small waist. I don't have a big waist. I just kind of have an average waist. So we're trying to build up those delts and lats as much as possible, focusing on our weak points this offseason, boys. So time to get dialed, get in the zone, and go smash this workout. So let's go.
Hey, yo. Best part of the gym, the pre-concert in the car. Slipping on the free, getting hyped, come on! But we see like that, they got a vomit, a vomit, a vomit, a lot like a gummy. When I dick that bitch, the CC Jesus, saw some rapture shit, throw my balls at a Pokemon, let's catch some shit, cause I'm flying like a new baby, one mat wing. Me and this mic is your Mortal Kombat team. I want some head, I'm thinking I'll zombie sting. Beaming a pistol, it look like Hadouken. Like Mayday, 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 Mayday. Tell these pussy rappers that it's time to vacate. Rob your lady. Told her put her hands up high in the air like she about to hit the nay-nay. They say I'm cray-cray. Can't control a nigga like we're shooting from the AK. But they give me rubbers, I'm a walking, breathing payday. How they biting swaggers, that nigga got a ray-bays. Get away, get away, get away, get away. Better do you a do. Wayne Wade, fade away. You sipping Haterade, I'm sipping Gatorade with a lean in and then I call it a fadeaway. I'm so toxic. Fog hop up on my dick. I think I'm a pilot. Cause she in my cockpit, plumber, puppet, get face like I Skyped it, then I ate that light bulb.
All right, real quick, look at that.
That is beautiful.
That's so beautiful.
Outside, go outside more. Yo. No one else goes, right. No one goes outside.
Two little quick questions that I can answer real quick. First one, height and weight. This one got asked a lot. I'm 5'11", and right now I'm like 202 pounds. So we're bulking hard, goal is 230. The next question is, how many siblings do I have? I got 4 siblings. I'm the youngest of 5. I got 4 older siblings. My oldest sibling being 33 years old. You guys know that's a special age. Comment down below before I say it. That's the age Jesus died. Our Lord and Savior, legend, 33. That's going to be a monumental year. I cannot wait for that birthday. Well, all right, boys. We're about to go peek and train. So let's get after it. All right, boys. So I just hit the 100s for like a super, super easy 8. It felt like I could have hit that for like 15 or 20 reps. So we're gonna go straight to the 110s. The most I hit that for was like my last workout or the workout before. I hit the 110s for 10. So I'm gonna try to hit those for maybe like a dozen today. I don't think I'm gonna go past that. I'm just gonna try and AMRAP that. So we're gonna see what happens, see how they feel. But trainer's feeling really good. Gonna get Justin to give me a little lift off and we should be chilling, boys. We're about to go destroy this weight. Trying to grow those delts, baby.
When he figures it out, it's all mental. He's gonna bang out 25 reps right here, watch.
That was what I was trying to hit. Did it for a 12 piece. Literally starting to PR almost every workout now. It's amazing. Strength is going through the roof right now.
We PR'd because he's wearing this shirt, baby.
Yeah, are you kidding me? Look at this.
Look at that shit. Are you kidding?
All right, give it the riser cut. Prop it. Make it a wide neck. OP. Or you can go Edward Scissorhands on your throat.
D5 9.
Now, guys, we're going to start hitting back now. Joey's showing you a great movement to warm up those lats. Rev up those fryers.
Now this is why you want to hit back with us, because if you hit back and follow our programs, you're going to turn into a house just like Joey. Insert the picture where we took for Young LA. There he is on the screen looking like an absolute house. And he's just standing there. So, first question on this Q&A is hack squats or back squats?
Honestly, like for overall leg growth, I would probably say, bro, I'd probably say like back squats. Everyone prefers like hack squats over barbell squats, but ever since I started doing barbell squats consistently the last like 3 or 4 months, my legs have like doubled in size. Like my legs have shot up. If I find a good comparison photo, I'm gonna toss on a little side by side right here.
Holy, look at that side by side.
Do your squats. I would say barbell squats, but if you do have a bad lower back, and definitely run hack squats, you can just focus like all your attention on your legs in general. So, because it's on that fixed path, it's almost like a Smith machine. So if you do have like back problems or anything like that, or even like knee problems, I would definitely recommend hack squat. But if you're a healthy individual, back squat.
I do hack squats because of my lower back. I have some issues in it. So hack squats, perfect for me. Second question. Are you Patrick Bateman, sir?
Well.
No comment. Yes, I am.
All right, so what is the weight? What is the goal? When's the show? Current weight is 202 pounds. Goal is to get up to a bare minimum 225 pounds, maybe 230, just depending on how I'm feeling. Then I'm gonna cut down, start my prep, probably do a show around like July or August of next summer, so summer 2023, I will be competing again. I'm gonna be competing in my first OCB Natural Pro Show, because I did win my Natural Pro card in my first show I did, so I'm gonna be competing in my first pro show in men's physique, and then I think I'm gonna try and do classic physique as well in the OCB Federation, and then I also want to do men's physique at an NPC show, see how I stack up against guys that, you know, are unnatural, and I know some are natural that do an NPC show, but just kind of see how I stack up against guys that non-drug tested show. So that's pretty much the current goal at the moment. All right, so just finished up some heavy dumbbell shoulder press. Now we're moving on just to span a lot of rear delts and side lateral raises. Whenever I do shoulder days, I typically only do like one press because it really just targets a lot of your front delt. You don't need to work it any more than really like a couple working sets of a heavy press. So we're gonna move on to another question. Reducing water retention strategies. So I'm not the biggest scientific guy and all the kind of the ins and outs of everything, but my best little tips for it is one, just overall decrease your sodium intake. There's a lot of sodium in like a bunch of the sauces that you use, like in barbecue sauce, mustard, kind of things like that. So you could lower just the intake of your sauces and kind of other thing that just holds sodium. The other thing is you are probably dehydrated, so try to drink at least a gallon of water a day. That will help also not hold as much water. And the other thing is in some fruits, like apples, bananas, strawberries, things like that, and watermelon, I think, and a few others, they're like very high in potassium, and that kind of like cancels out the sodium or does something to the sodium. It pretty much like lowers it, and it's gonna also help reduce your water retention. So those are kind of like my three biggest tips for kind of helping with that. And then the next question, this was from the Snap Gang. And if you guys have me on Snapchat, by the way, you guys are legends. If you don't, go ahead and add it. It's literally riser.fit. I just kind of post anything on everything on Snapchat. Now, next question is advice for beginners in the gym. I'm gonna hit you with not my number one tip, because there's like a lot of number one tips, but first thing that comes to mind is focus on like form over weight. I can remember clear as day when I was like 17 years old, 18 years old, doing like quarter reps on like squats, on dumbbell press, kind of things like that, or like swinging heavy dumbbells just to get a few reps. Like, you don't need to be doing any of that. You're gonna get hurt. That's like one thing that could happen if you go try to go super heavy on deadlift, squats, things like that. It also kind of correlates to like ego lifting in a sense. Like, you wanna lift more, you wanna be like maybe impress the people in the gym for whatever reason. We all kind of think like that. Just really just focus on form, do the weight that you can control. I'd much rather see you guys, you know, doing like, you know, 50 pound dumbbell presses, full form, just getting a good contraction and squeeze, than doing like the 85s for like quarter reps, things like that. That's also gonna help with overall muscle growth by just doing really good form and having a really good mind-muscle connection.
Piggybacking what he was saying, trust me, no one is looking at you in the gym, no one gives a fuck, we're all on different journeys. I was the same exact way going into the gym. When I first started going, I was super anxious. I thought everyone was looking at me, when in reality, no one gave a shit and no one was taking the time out of the day to look at you during you working out. So like he was saying, truly work on form. I'd rather have you curling 15 pound dumbbells other than 35, just swinging them all the time. So don't become an ego lifter. And another giant tip I can tell you is learn from us. Take as many progress pictures as you can in the beginning. I know at first, when you're starting your journey, wherever you are, like, it can be really intimidating to take pictures of yourself because you're kind of ashamed where you are or where you're starting. I feel you in the same exact way. I didn't want to take any of my progress pictures in the beginning, but I did. So take as many as you can, because that the more content you have, you'll look back in like 2 or 3 months of you consistently going to the gym, you look in these pictures and you'll see a difference, I can promise you. But another thing where you're kind of also piggybacking what he was saying is just staying consistent in the gym, because when I first started my whole weight loss journey, it took me 3 whole months to see any type of like a difference. Relying on the photos I had, I was able to see a difference. So just take as many progress pictures as you can, and like I said, no one is looking at you in the gym, so don't ego lift.
And also what he said about progress pictures, like, he said it took him like, you know, 3 months to really see like results.
and obviously everyone comes from like different backgrounds. We're all playing the same game right now in the gym, but we're all like, you know, starting at different points. We have different goals and stuff. No one starts out the exact same. I was super skinny. I was putting on weight fast. If I can find these month by month photos, I'm gonna put them on the screen, but I was digging for them in the gym. I couldn't find them anywhere. But like my first month in the gym, like my physique was like not night and day, but I was like, damn, this kid's like been hitting the gym. Like I got good genetics and stuff and the weight, I was just eating a lot of food. I was training hard my first month. And I'm gonna try my best to find these pictures because like in 1 month I saw like pretty nasty gains. And my first 3 months, it was like ridiculous. The newbie gains were through the roof. And then what he said too about like people not looking at you in the gym, like if there's anyone in the gym that is judging people and anything like that, that is their personal problem. They probably have bad things going on in their life where they want to judge others, make fun of people. That is something that you guys should not worry about at all. You cannot stress over things that are not in your control. No one is judging you, I promise that. Like the gym, like where we go to Alphaland, and this gym is just such positive vibes, positive just environment. No one judges each other here. Like biggest guys here are the nicest guys you'll ever meet. Like we're really close with some of the biggest guys at Alphaland, and they are huge. They look like big scary monsters and they're teddy bears if you get to know them. So I promise you, like everyone in the gym are very nice and they want to just help each other. Like the gym is a community. We're one. We just want to bring each other up. We want everyone just to be happy with their physique. And yeah,
the gym can be intimidating, but don't let it be intimidating.
Be a part of the journey, you know. Get in the gym, lock in, put on some headphones, preferably listen to Suicide Boys, and take some Dial Pre and kill your lifts every day, baby. Let's go.
I'll throw you a question.
All right.
What's Now, I can't relate, so I'm going to ask for all the people that's on his side that can relate. What's a beginner tip for someone that's just trying to put on some weight?
You just got to learn to eat. I know it's easier said than done. You just got to eat fat meals, and you got to eat like kind of consistently throughout the day. Like if you have like a, you know, small stomach or you're not hungry that often, try to kind of like almost teach your stomach to eat meals every like 2 or 3 hours, just consistently get food in. If you are in like school and you maybe can't do that, you know, I know you might only have like a lunch break and like that's kind of it. Try your best to get a very fat, big breakfast in before you go to school. Wake up a little bit early for that. Get a big time breakfast in, then have whatever lunch. And then when you get back home, just feast on something and get really good like calorie dense foods. So anyone that's struggling to put on weight, invest in cashews and peanut butter. Those are like my two biggest things. Like when I was bulking my last bulk, I had cashews with like 3 meals. Like you do a little handful and you down them one bite, it's like 200 calories and like 12 grams of fat. It's good healthy fats. Peanut butter, bro, I mean, I know everyone loves peanut butter. You could be 3, 4, or 5 tablespoons in, you're 1,000 calories deep just like that. That's kind of my biggest tip for people struggling to put on weight. I have a counter question. So obviously we came from different backgrounds. So what is your best advice for people starting out that were overweight and try to kind of learning to dial maybe their food intake down with being in the gym and kind of balancing both and not going like insane?
Well, I'm not gonna lie to you. A beginner tip that I can give to a lot of people is truly start to like learn what you're putting in your body. And what I mean by that is like turning over the package of what you're about to eat and look at the numbers. Like start reading the actual numbers of the calories, how many servings of like per whatever. Look at the proteins, look at the carbs, look at all the sugars, because you need to start tracking this now. If you're gonna want to put a goal number in your brain for, you know, calories or your new set macros, you're gonna have to start really trying to learn like what is in an apple, how many calories are in a banana, or a certain amount of eggs. Just starting to really like nail these numbers into your brain, so eventually you don't even have to bring out your phone every time to look up like what do I need to do. It's all just gonna become like muscle memory after a long time. So just literally practice on reading your macros in the back of any of your labels. But I hate to say, you just got to be in a calorie deficit. How many people preach that? It is simply the truth. You just got to be, you have to be burning more calories than you are consuming. So lowering your calorie intake and burning a shit ton of calories. I would also recommend, you literally need to do cardio. Like cardio is hell. I hated doing it. I still hate doing it, but I've learned to love it because I know that doing cardio is going to get me to the results that I want to get to. And I want to get to my goal. Doing cardio is key. Like I'm telling you, if you want to lose weight, you just need to do cardio. Just literally work your way up to like these longer sessions. So go on the stairs. I remember when I first started, I could only do the stairs for 2 minutes and I was like gassed. I was like, there's no way. Now I do stairs for 35 to 40 minutes with ease. I'm not even like struggling at all. It's all about journey. It's all about a process. So like starting out on the treadmill, slowly start to increase the incline, slowly start to increase the speed. Throw on a good YouTube, and you've got Netflix, just do something to stay either on your phone, and the cardio won't even feel like cardio. But truly, calorie deficit, take it day by day. Take literally a progress picture almost every fucking day, honestly, because that's the coolest thing ever when you get to look back months of your hard work and get to see like, holy shit, I did that.
My mom didn't do that. My friends didn't do that. Like, I did it. So it's really cool to see your progress in pictures. And but yeah, calorie deficit, do your cardio, stay consistent.
I'm going to touch on one thing, because a couple of you guys did slide up and ask. You kind of said, how can you make cardio fun? So there's a couple answers I'm going to say to that. The first answer is, one, you just got to suck it up and do the treadmill, do the Stairmaster, whatever it is. But if you're not in like a prep lifestyle and you don't need to do that, but you want to get like still some cardio in, something that we do a lot, like one, you can just go on a fat walk. Like, find a dope nature spot. Nature is absolutely beautiful. Find a park. Walk somewhere for like an hour or two. Just get steps in. The outside feels amazing. The outside air will literally like refresh you and just make you feel better.
Actually, walking is the best form of cardio. Yeah. You will burn more calories and lose more weight walking than you will if you sprint every day or jog or do whatever you have to do. So recommend, truly, just going outside and walking with your friends.
It's so easy. You could walk for like 2 hours. You're not going to be winded at all. Your feet might hurt a little bit, but other than that, you're going to be fine. The other thing I would say too is like something that me, Justin, and Justice do a lot. We'll go to an open park. We'll bring like a football or a frisbee and we'll like run routes. Like, so we kind of do like little sprints every now and then. We obviously walk around when we're like throwing in and stuff. But that's just a fun way to do cardio. Like, get your friends together, you know, play basketball, throw the football, throw the baseball, throw the frisbee, do something. Just play sports outside too for like an hour or two. That's like the only other way to kind of make cardio a little more fun and enjoyable.
Tell you what, before every cardio session, tell yourself this before you do the cardio. God, this cardio is going to make me look so sexy. And then you do
so
it.
So sick.
That's what I'm saying. It's gonna make me look so sick. Why wouldn't I do it? So go into every cardio session with that mindset, you win life.
And you can't tell me you don't feel just absolutely amazing when you're like drenched in sweat, bro, and you're just like,
that's the best feeling in the world.
Like, literally. You look insane, you feel amazing. Cardio's love, cardio's life. Let's go finish this workout.
We're entering gym 2, where they usually play Suicide Boys, our anthem.
Hey, bro, can I kick up a song? You ever listen to Suicide Boys? I love Suicide Boys. Bro, play like your favorite song by them. We're a favorite couple songs by them.
Oh, man.
Nightmare Choir?
Nightmare Choir?
No.
In a couple seconds, you're about to hear Suicide Boys, baby.
Bro, Cameron, legend.
Yeah, Cameron, if you're watching this, which you're not, you're a legend.
Alright, this exercise is money. Rear delt pulls, thumb over the dumbbell, pretty much fully bent over. Pull straight through the elbow. No, make sure he's there. How's that feel?
Feels real good. So we're leaving, and then Joey says, I'm gonna go do 405 deadlifts. I said, you're kidding, right?
Kind of a little second wind of energy, second burst, so I figured might as well end the workout with deadlifts, I guess. So we're at 315 right now. I gotta go socks on the wood, though. Definitely not ideal. The wood's a little bit slippery, but I have, like, Air Maxes on. I can't deadlift in Air Maxes. I need flat shoes or need to go shoeless, so... We're gonna see how this goes, we're gonna see how it feels, boys, and we'll see what we end up pulling, but yeah, a little workout finisher, I guess. There's only one problem with this right now. Like, this side is super indented in the ground, so this bar never stays, like,
if you like rotate it
and like leave it, it's gonna like roll this way every time because this is like dipped. So we kind of got to little balance it, and so we're just gonna see how it goes. These will save your life. Bursa grips are insane. These are expensive. They were literally like $90, but I lost my last pair. But these things are amazing. I prefer them over straps 100%. All my friends use them like when they train with me. They always use this over their straps. So I would definitely recommend, if you have the money for it, definitely invest in Bursa grips. These are amazing. They make deadlifts much better, and just anything that uses a lot of grip strength, these are just a lifesaver. So this is what I use pretty much every time I deadlift and kind of do like heavy stuff where my grip strength might give out before like the muscle I'm training with. So these are really helpful. Better get dialed in and see how this feels, I guess. Plates on the bar. This is pretty much like not my PR, but like I haven't gone past it. If I'm able to hit this like at the end of a workout pretty gas, that would be sick. So we're gonna see what happens. We're gonna be careful though. I kind of hit my shin a little bit and I have a shin tattoo, so I definitely don't want to fuck that up. So we're gonna try and just pull it nice and smooth and see what happens.
If I make any deadlift to breeze, I do this with Justice all the time. 135. B-U-T-T-E-R. That spells butter.
That literally moved faster than, like, my last deadlift session when I was, like, this was my first exercise and I had all the energy. I'm going to look at this book real quick and then I'm going to let you know if I'm going to go up. See, I would be a fool not to go up, realistically, for how fast that went on a Saturday night post-workout. So, I'm going to think about what to put on and then I'm going to show you guys in just a second. Alright boys, so we got 545 on the bar. This will be an all-time PR for deadlifts in general. So yeah, I'm gonna rest up for a few minutes, get super dialed in, and see if I can literally PR right here. I'm only like 200, 201 pounds. The most I ever pulled at my peak bulk last year was, I think, 545, but I did it sumo. So technically I feel like conventional, this would be a PR, because, like, I don't know, conventional is harder, quote unquote. A little bit harder than last time. About to play my favorite. I've showed you guys this a number of times. R by Ghostman. Come on. And Scarlex. Whoever that Scarlex guy is, he's a rapper. Bro's shredded. He looks insane. He's got like an anime physique. PR, baby. Let's go. I guess. Random PR. I wasn't even going to deadlift today. I literally wanted to focus all my energy on the dumbbell shoulder press, so I don't really know what that was. I guess like a surprise PR. This is literally what I said too, and I made like a TikTok about this, and it kind of blew up. Like, I just go for a PR when I'm feeling it. Like, I just decided to deadlift out of the blue. 495 flew. Like, there's no reason not to go up. Don't, like, schedule your fucking PR and program. Like, just lift heavy when you feel strong, so... That was actually awesome. Let's go. Road to like 600 deadlifts, I guess. I don't even know what's going through my head right now. I'm kind of winded, so I'll be back in just a second.
Moon's dark side. Tell you what, start looking at the moon more.
All right, guys, now that I kind of gathered my thoughts after that deadlift, very hype about that. Literally an all-time deadlift PR. I hit that same weight like when I was like 210 pounds last bulk and I did it sumo. So I figured a conventional 200 pound, same weight, definitely a PR, so very happy with that. Super excited to be deadlifting consistently again. And yeah, the strength has been feeling honestly amazing. This is like my third or fourth PR in something in like 3 or 4 weeks. So the strength is shooting up, body weight's feeling amazing. The bulk is just going very, very well. Very happy with the progress so far. So now boys, I'm gonna end with one last question. So there's like a lot of ways like we could really approach this question, so I'm just gonna kinda answer it in maybe one of the ways. What's the thing that you hold onto the most that keeps moving you forward? So that could be honestly like in the gym, that could be in life, like what is that one thing? And honestly for me it's just like, I know it's kinda like, not oversaturated, but like we truly only live once and we only get to experience this place one time. There's no reason just not to truly like enjoy every moment. Any bad experiences in life, you just gotta learn and grow from it. You just gotta keep growing and just be happy with where we are. Like, Earth is absolutely beautiful. It's the best place you can be. And again, guys, we only get one chance at it. Enjoy every moment and do what you wanna do. Don't try to please anyone to get other people's, you know, positive opinions on you. Just do everything that you wanna do, chase your dreams. We dropped out of school to do what we wanna do and inspire you guys. And our life has been amazing ever since. So yeah, guys, just enjoy life. We get one chance, boys.
And to what he was saying about having one life, do something that you love every single day. If it doesn't bring you enjoyment, what are you doing it? But just truly staying blessed, go outside more, start reading, truly spend time with your friends, be more present. Everyone is so worried about the future and what's to come, they're not even literally stopping and looking around. Like, truly start being more present, start having good conversations with your friends and your family. Just be here, be present as you can be. You only have one life, so live to it as best as you can.
So I'm going to end with you guys a quote. And if you remember in the beginning of the video, I talked about that Meditations book, Marcus Aurelius, that philosopher. So he has kind of a quote. It's not word for word, but pretty much what he says is, waking up every day is a true blessing. Like, live live, love, and laugh with the people around you. Like, just appreciate life. Like, never take waking up for granted. Like, that is amazing. You get to open your eyes to another day of life, another day of living, loving, everything. Like, life is a true blessing. Just never take that for granted. If you got a roof over your head and food on the table, W life, bro. You're living, you're having a great life. Do what you love. And yeah, boys, if you enjoyed the video, smash that like button and subscribe. If you enjoy the random PR, subscribe. That's gonna keep happening. Also, I'm gonna make it noted in this video, November 19th in Dallas. I think at the Metroplex Gym, we're doing a vision meetup. Myself, Justin, Justice, Hogan, Lucas, and many others are gonna be, I'm pretty sure, at the Metroplex Gym in Dallas. So be there November 19th, it's gonna be sick. We're doing a pop-up. We're giving out free pre-workout, free samples of some of like the new, I think some of the new Black Friday stuff, bench competition, deadlift competition. It's gonna be a lot of fun. I'm gonna try and PR there myself. So be there, boys. If you're in the Dallas area or anywhere in Texas, make the drive, pull up. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Excited to meet all you guys. So yeah, boys, if you enjoyed the video, smash that like button, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.